Course B1P1-2. Covering the topics: User Interface, Edge Blend, Simple Hole. Well, you can also download a drawing in PDF format for this part. If you want, you can download and print it or display it on a second screen. Edge Blend. The part from the last course is now to be processed further. In the next step, we do an edge blend. The command edge blend offers several options. If required, these can be selected by clicking the small gear wheel at the top left, the so-called dialog window options. And by another click on less, be hidden. And of course, be unhidden by another click on more. The normal standard edge blend is created with the setting G1 tangent and circular. Create edge blend. Enter the radius and press enter. Once again, the note, the value is only accepted by NX after pressing enter. Choose now the edge to blend by left click. The chosen edge now displays the counter 1. Select another edge to test. The counter now stands at 2. To deselect the edge, press and hold the shift key. And click on the additionally selected edge again. The edge is deselected again, and the counter jumps back to 1. Now, confirm with OK. In NX, selected objects can be deselected again by holding down the shift key. Double-clicking on the area of the edge blend takes you back to the menu. Here you can change the settings at will. And finish by clicking OK. Hole menu. The requirements for the two holes are as follows. The position of the hole, sized 16, should be defined by a snap point, the center point of the radius. The position of the hole, sized 10, on the other hand, should be defined by dimensions. The command hole includes 6 different types of holes, which are offered in the drop-down list above. By a click on Show Shortcuts, the options can be selected directly. To show the options as a drop-down list again, simply select the Hide Shortcuts. NX just retains the settings when creating commands, but not when changing commands afterwards. For example, if such settings are made when creating a new hole, NX saves the changed settings in the user interface. However, if the settings are made when changing a hole, they are not saved. Hole variants. A hole without a counter bore or a countersink is created with the hole type, simple. The diameter can only be specified individually by using the setting, custom. The other two hole types create standard holes whose size is selected here. Or holes for screws, the diameter of which is selected by selecting screw size. Depending on the selection, the input mask changes. The drilling direction is normally perpendicular to the surface. We will do another exercise later that deviates from this rule. The depth limit can be set by a value or one of the options. The thumbnails explain the different options. Hole on snap point. Well, now we come to the positioning of the hole, sized 16 via a snap point. Select the settings shown in the hole command. Select snap points. And make sure that the snap point option is set to center of arc. Click on the edge of the edge blend. The size of the hole and the depth options can also be edited in the graphics window. Done! The hole is created by clicking OK. The center of the arc is now firmly connected to the center of the hole. If the radius is changed, the position of the hole also changes. Quick pick. Let us go back for a second. If you don't move the cursor for more than 1 second, three dots will appear at the cursor. After a left click, a list is displayed from which the center point can also be selected. So if you want to make a selection from the list, you simply have to hold the cursor motionless over an object for about 1 second and then click. This timer can even be adjusted. The delay can be selected in 5 levels under Menu, Preferences, Selection. Level 5 is the biggest delay. If the option is deactivated, a selection in the list is no longer possible. This setting only applies to this session. Position the hole using dimensions. On we go with the hole size 10, which is to be positioned using the dimensions. Start the hole command again, the settings for the last hole are still set. Move the cursor over the surface of the part. A coordinate system becomes visible. The dimensioning is created for this coordinate system. Move the coordinate system to the corner and left click. The dimensioning is created automatically. Select the dimensioning by clicking and change the values. Change hole. The holes created can be selected and edited by double-clicking on the hole surface. After selecting the hole, which was positioned using dimensioning, further holes can be created, which are dimensioned to the same point. Further courses will cover more options for positioning holes.